one of the first few days in the hospital, a nurse had asked me, you know, what had happened, and I told her, and she said she had gotten stuck in the traffic from the accident on her way into work that day. She bought me this little fox. I'm gonna... I'm gonna recount what happened for you guys. Really. Really don't want to go back there. But I want to tell everyone what happened. I already posted about it on Instagram when it happened, but I just didn't have it in me to make a video. I can't watch any of the Dust Buggy videos, really. They just make me sad. I know one day I'll be really happy looking back at them. It's really hard because when I do go back and see just little clips, it feels exactly how it felt when he was here. That part of me. Big part of me. The first time I saw the video was spent, I heard him talking in it, working on the car. I felt how you feel when you haven't seen a friend in a long time, and you finally get to see. This loneliness that you didn't know you had. This is gonna be really hard for me. Because I kind of spend all my time avoiding thinking about the accident, at least in certain ways. In the morning. Some nights I just can't sleep. I Spence and I were two peas in the pod. We went together everywhere. I'm a pretty introverted person, and I don't feel comfortable around many people. And Spence was different. He was someone I felt comfortable with almost right away. And I think it's because he's kind of the same way as me. And we both just vibed, you know, on the same kind of level. The whole week leading up to the accident, we were having a really good week. We had some really deep, meaningful talks. Every time I think about it too much, I'm back there. I don't remember everything, but I'll tell you what I do remember. It was a peaceful day, beautiful, sunny, good weather. A little hot, but it was starting to cool off a little from summer. I was talking to my mom on the phone in our bedroom. Spencer was watching. Spencer was watching the new vid. I stayed up all night making. He had just finished it, and he wanted to go out gas up the Suburb to prepare for work the next day, Monday, because it was Sunday. I thought that was a good idea. Let me go pee real quick. Didn't think anything of it. Walked down the street to the Suburban, drove to the gas station. I thought about going in and getting an horchata, but I didn't. I had said something nitpicky about Spencer's driving, and he jokingly said to me when we got to the gas station, "Well, do you want to drive?" He knew the answer. No. I said, "You're right, I'm sorry. I'll stop backseat driving." Left the gas station. There's a couple ways we can get to our house. The light turned red to go straight as we were coming up to it. So Spence does what he usually does when that happened. And he got into the left turn lane to go up San Francisco Canyon. You can turn off the canyon into the neighborhoods from there. Well, when we got to that turnout, someone was on our butt, you know, going really fast. And Spencer gets nervous when he makes right-hand turns or left-hand turns. When someone's just, like, riding you, he thinks that they'll, you know, hit him. And so he didn't turn. Or maybe we forgot at the moment. I can't even remember anymore. The canyon road has a straightaway, but we were actually narrowing the end of the straightaway. At the end of the straightaway, there's a long, elongated curve. We started to make the curve. Seeing is there was a person riding our ass. I told Spencer somebody's still riding our butt. right at that moment, I saw a big dust cloud shoot up from a tire. And I remember looking at it quizzically, thinking, what? That's weird. Because my brain hadn't been able to process what had happened yet. And tire in the dirt. Everything slowed real fast. I know what they mean by adrenaline. You can do some crazy things. I saw the driver of the BMW had his hand on the right side of the steering wheel. It's a left-handed curve. Don't know why his hand was there. Don't know where his right hand was. Probably looking at his phone instead of the road. I saw him wildly swing his arm from this side of the wheel to that side of the wheel. And right then and there, I knew we were I had enough time to widen my eyes and gasp before the tires screeched. I saw the passenger of the BMW throw his hands out to the sides. Last second. I saw the guy in the Beamer sitting in the rear. Was on the passenger side. I was later told he was on the driver's side, but I believe he wasn't wearing a seatbelt and he got moved over that much, because I know what I saw. And I didn't see any seat belts. But the last thing I saw, I got to look at Spencer. He wasn't scared. He was determined. He yanked the wheel to the right. He slammed on the brakes. When I came to, it was in the ER. It isn't just the accident. That was scary. Yeah, that was the scariest part. But I've never been waterboarded before, but I'd imagine that it feels kind of like a flashback does, like a really bad one. It's not just the first flashback. When I start talking about the accident, have you ever held your breath a really long time where you really needed to breathe, and when you finally got to air, you went and you sucked in as much air as you could? That's kind of what being in a flashback feels like when you finally get pulled out of it. It may be a 4-second flashback, but when you finally come back, it's like you're taking the biggest breath of fresh air because you've just been starved of oxygen for that long. In 7 months. I now have a compression sleeve that I have to wear 24/7. Paying attention when I got it. walked out of Kaiser and I turned to my dad and I was like, wait, I have to wear this thing all the time. It's got a zipper that goes all the way up. Goes all the way up here. It's got a glove with a zipper. So now I say I get to wear a compression sleeve 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. I'm so lucky. The dogs have these little piggies that they love to play with, little toy piggies, squeaky pigs. I thought about taking two and stuffing them right here in the hole. When I thought about that, I just couldn't stop laughing. Yeah, I don't know. This is pretty much where I'm at emotionally. I don't fucking know. And people are like, oh, are you okay? Or you over the dead boyfriend thing? It's like, no. Am I ever gonna be over it? It's not like I voluntarily chose this. Does it feel like I got the biggest fuck you from God in the world? Yeah. But I don't know his plan. I don't know what could have been, you know? I just think nobody's getting out alive, you know? And this life sucks. Yeah. I guess I could show you, show you guys how I'm healing, how I'm coming along, you know? Just getting there. Here, let's turn. These are my burns. It's way back here. And my arm's a little, oh, it's got sores developing. And that's from steroid injections. Ugh, painful. Hopefully they work, but, well, here's the damage. Yeah, and the compression sleeve is causing my elbow to become sore as well. I'm pretty sure when the accident happened, I was holding my arm like that because that's how the burn pattern goes. arm's a little... Oh, it's got sores developing. And that's from steroid injections. Ugh. Painful. Hopefully they work. But, well... Here's the damage. Yeah, and the compression sleeve is causing my elbow to become sore as well. I'm pretty sure when the accident happened, I was holding my arm like that because that's how the burn pattern goes. There's that guy. Let's see the calf as well. A little bit of skin graft donor sites. The nice checkerboard for my ankle fixture. More skin graft donor size. Oh, here's a nice little burn they cut out. Oh, another one. Here, another burn they cut out. Let's see. For the most part, uninjured and mostly uninjured everywhere. Here. Which would explain why I'm still alive. Busted my head open. Busted my nose. Busted my cheekbone. Broke my hand in two places. Cracked ribs. Broke my back in two places. Lost two toes. Shattered my ankle, shattered most of the bones in my left foot. Yeah. It was not fun. Oh. I mean, at this point, you know, I'm doing better than I could probably ask for. Is that comforting? No. You know. I mean, I was a brand spanking healthy, God, athletic as ever, 27-year-old. Normal. Never broken a bone in my body. And now I've broken over 13. So, I used to faint when I got my blood taken. And now they stick me with the needle and I laugh. You know how many times I had to get blood drawn in the hospital? Every day before surgery, I had 12 or 13 surgeries. A lot of those were where they put me under and cleaned my burns and stuff. But that's not nothing. That's them putting you to sleep so that they can scrub the shit out of your dead skin. And when you wake up, you feel that dead skin they scrubbed. I think if I ever have to do another skin graft surgery again, I just want to be put down. Just... get the shotgun, fucking do it nice and fast, right in the head, between the eyes or something, you know. Please, please, for the love of God, don't make me do the skin grafts. I did it once. Didn't know how bad it was going to be. Didn't know the surgery was going to be this bad. I mean, I'd had surgeries, you know, since the accident had happened. I had surgery. Nope. That was different. That was... They skinned me alive on my entire body. And then the grafts got infected. So they had to do another one. So they reharvested me in all of the same places. Yeah, it didn't feel so good when I came out of that surgery. I remember I came out and they have you fast. No food, no water for 12 hours before the surgery. I came out of that surgery intending on drinking water and going pee, and I ended up waking up so fucked up that I passed right the fuck out when I got to the room. And I looked at my mom and dad and I was like, I'm gonna be asleep the rest of the night. And then I pretty much was. Foot hurts so bad right now. I hurt so bad all over. God. Sucks. Since the accident, every day for 7 months, something hurts, something itches, something's uncomfortable. Sometimes I wonder, what, you know, what did I do? Did I do something? Did I anger God? Did we do something wrong? I don't understand. I don't know. Only he knows those things. I'm just a crazy woman rambling to herself at 3 a.m. now. Yeah, maybe there's something in there that'll be useful.